Joining me now is a former member of the FBI Joint Terrorism Task Force, Steve Rogers. And at times when you and I have talked about these sorts of things that have happened, you want to know the latest and the details so that you can immediately start to put this together. So can I add something to your bin?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So I interviewed a short time ago 15-year-old Layla Butler. She's a sophomore at the school. She gave me a detail that I hadn't heard in quite the same way before. I said, without naming a name, would you have had any idea who would have done this? She said, no. She said, however, 3 months ago, we had a threat come in. And our school went into lockdown because I said, have you ever practiced anything like this before, rehearsed it, trained for it, that sort of thing? And she talked about how this was a false threat. And what made today so different from their original reaction to the lockdown and all of that with that, and how they would act with someone on campus with a gun, is that somebody had pulled, and we were told the gunman, based on witnesses, had pulled a fire alarm. You have all of that. Your expertise tells you what?
Harris, as we've quite often said, when the forensics investigation is completed on his computer equipment, iPads, phones, electronic equipment, the police are going to find out a lot. We may find out that over a period of time, this individual has been posting tips, posting some threats. We may find out that more students, as they come forward, will say, yeah, I remember him saying this, saying that. But there's something haunting me right now, and it's something that you have said over and over and over again. And we've sat here many times. You've asked the same question of elected officials. What are we doing about it? What are you doing on Capitol Hill? Harris, the time has come for committee hearings, for studies and assessments to end. The time for action is now. And we've talked about, and parents asked me this morning in my own school district, what are we to do? And there's two answers to that. Short term, police officers, well-trained police officers have to be put in our schools, and metal detectors have to be put in our schools. That's in the immediate short term. Long term, we do have to look at the mental health issues, but more so, we have to get the parents. And we have to get parents to understand that, like the congressman just said, if you say something or see something and even sense something, a lot of us, you know, our instincts.
But they did in Parkland. Those kids did speak up.
Yes.
We knew that in Parkland that the suspect and all of that wasn't allowed to come onto campus with a certain kind of a big bag and
yes.
that sort of thing.
Yes.
You had a lot of information.
You did.
But you didn't protect the target.
That's
necessarily.
Right.
Although you had resource officers there, which from the video, unfortunately.
Well, it's and there was a breakdown.
Might
there.
Not have
and,
done much.
Yeah, and it's a shame. It's a tragedy. But you had an armed officer in Illinois just yesterday or the day before who saved a lot of lives.
Yes.
You know, and this officer who was shot today, I believe there is was there an officer shot?
Well, you heard Congressman Weber just saying he's fighting for his life
yeah.
right now. We've gotten a couple of hospital updates. He was shot close to the chest. He's lost a significant amount of blood. So, yes, he's in critical.
He engaged this suspect. Imagine if he wasn't there, how many more students may have been shot. My point is this. We've got to put an end to the committee hearings and the studies and the assessments. Let's take some action. And the action is immediate.
You think we know what we need to know?
Oh, well, I think we know what we need to know. We need to know that, and we know that there's been blood shed in schools across this country that are unnecessary because we, whether elected officials or society in general, have failed to respond the way we should respond, and that is use every means necessary to protect our students.
Let me add in something, and it speaks to what you're saying. So earlier in the program, I spoke with Congressman Roger Williams, who was part of that congressional baseball practice and was shot during that. And he says his life is forever changed. One of the things he says he's going to do next week is push this bill. He's already reached out to Education Secretary DeVos to talk about, you know, spin that $63 billion that's sitting there now with education. And he says you've got to protect the target. So what's step one?
Step one.
So you got the money to do it.
Yeah, you got the money. Step one, people should be flooding their state legislatures, and particularly the state as well as Congress, with demands to bring police officers in school. Look, there's not going to be a Wild West in the schools. I was a cop for 38 years.
Yeah,
I was in the schools every day.
So what is the fear there? That's you'll hear from some people,
yeah.
Well, it's going to be this way.
Well, for some reason, they fear that there's going to be untrained people in the schools with guns. There's just a lot of unnecessary. There's nothing but fear but fear itself, as Roosevelt said. So what we need to do is to take the action necessary, and that action is get cops in our schools as a first step.
Metal detectors. bulletproof glass. I mean, some of the schools have these things.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But not all of them.
Harden the targets.
Look, what's the downside? I've asked people against this. What is the downside to have armed officers, trained officers in these schools? Trained not only to confront an individual, but to engage them strategically so that there's no more loss of life.
Steve Rogers, thank you very much. I know your expertise is terrorism. And, you know, I had the conversation with A.G. Paxton. Are we in a place where maybe we might begin to call these domestic terror?
Yes.
We'll see what happens.
Thank you.
Appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Let's go now to Ted Williams.